When things are normal, Martha's table serves about 200 meals a day. But how do they continue serving meals during this time of social isolation? I'm joined by Executive Director Rhonda Candy from Martha's Table. Hey, Rhonda.
Hi, Donna. Hi. How are you?
How are you and the staff and the volunteers doing these days?
Well, we're doing very well, thank you. Unfortunately, though, we are minus our volunteers, those amazing folks that want to help us every single day. We've had to turn them away because we're trying to follow pandemic requirements and minimize the amount of people in and out of the space and for their benefit. But we sure do miss them.
And they'll be looking forward to coming back because you treat your volunteers very well there. So what had to change as a result of that?
Well, we've always been a group that believes in there's no job too big or too small. So we've all jumped in, all staff. I have a couple of youth. So they're going to be part of the Summer Jobs for Youth program, and they are helping as well. And we are just packaging and preparing and serving meals, takeout, of course. Yeah, takeout only.
All right. So people, so this would be the equivalent of a dinner meal. So it's the one where it's a dollar. Is that how this works?
Right. We serve now 7 days a week. We've gone Monday through Sunday, and we serve between 11 and 1. And during that time, we prepare a meal and serve it that is, we still want to do a hot meal. As you say, it's like a dinner. So okay. We might have ham and scalloped potatoes. We do a couple cold plates, but for the most part, it's a nice substantial meal. We offer a dessert, breads, anything that we have. Sometimes we're handing out Coke and chips. The Leon Center closed down and gave us a large donation of those. So different organizations have been donating, and we're happy to move those forward on their behalf. So guests don't come into the facility. They're greeted at the front door by one of the staff members, and we pass the donation of the meal out to them that way.
And then it's a matter of taking it away somewhere and enjoying it.
Yes, yes. Yeah. We do have a lot of people that are asking for forks and knives and spoons, so we kind of know that they're not going to take it home to enjoy it. Right. So,
and that's reality for a lot of people, unfortunately. So speaking of, you've had to suddenly start supplying a lot of things that you didn't before. How are you doing with that?
Well, we've had some support from the community. Takeout containers are a commodity because a lot of restaurants are also doing takeout meals as well. So we purchase a lot of those. We've received some funds from a private donor and from United Way. Again, individual restaurants have supported with containers and spoons and knives. So those things are all coming into play, and not to mention sanitizers, masks, and goggles, and gloves, and all those things that go with it. We're taking every precaution possible, and it is a chore to collect all those needed items.
Now, speaking of donations, you got a nice donation from Kojiko. Tell me about that.
We certainly did. I just saw that today, and it was a lovely surprise to come into work today and discover that, because that's going to provide meals for, I'm going to say, 400 people. Just consider that done. 400 meals. Thank you, Kojiko. And that's 400 people that are maybe newly unemployed, homeless, senior citizens. We even have students coming to the door. So that's a large number in the population of hungry people that are being helped. So I'd like to say thank you to Kojiko for that.
It's a good feeling for a company, to, especially when you're able to assign a number as 400 more people who aren't going to go to bed hungry as a result of what's going on. It seems like, and I don't know whether this is my imagination, but it seems like you can get food. A lot of places are stepping up, or is the need still really great out there?
There are new organizations offering food. There's a couple places now that have gone into the parks, or a couple parks that have an organization, and that's amazing. They are serving a lot of people by going into those, moving. They're portable, right? So they can reach people versus people coming to us. So there's a real benefit to that. So I'm happy that they're helping with this load of demand, because it really is great. Our numbers are up. They're seeing massive numbers, and the community is just in need.
Yeah. Are you seeing people that you didn't used to see, people who are there for the first time?
Absolutely. We are seeing people with families, more families. We're seeing young mothers coming up with small children, or they're coming up and they're asking for six meals because they've got people at home sharing the meals. So these are folks that we have not seen before, and I'm happy that they're visiting. Again, they could be newly unemployed, not really sure what to do, and I'm happy that they can access our service when they need to. That's always been Martha's mission. So that's happy to hear.
And you know, it's not anybody's fault that they're in this position. I think most people live paycheck to paycheck, and there was little notice that this was going to happen so you could put things in place. It all happened so quickly that suddenly we found ourselves isolated, and a grocery shopping trip became like a combat mission. That's what it always feels like when I do it anyway. So good for you. Yeah. I'm glad you're there for the community, and stay safe. What else can I say, Rhonda?
Well, thank you, Donna. I hope that we are able to be here as long as needed. That's always been my goal. Somebody will say, what's your 10-year goal to be here? If we're needed, we want to serve. And it's a community. It's not Martha's staff. It's not Martha's volunteers. Everybody, Kojiko, Leon's that I mentioned, many other donors, we can't do it. It takes a village. And that's an old saying, but it's alive and well here. We need help, and it's a community effort. When I think of receiving funds from people, I think of you now as a partner. I don't think of you, you're taking part in this, in its relationship now. So it's important that we stay fresh and stay needed, if meet the needs as they arise, is what I'm saying.
Thanks so much for being with us, and continued good luck, and stay safe.
Thank you. We'll work on it. Same to you.